Hi, I'm Doug Baldwin, and I'd like to welcome you to this mini-lecture on nAry relations. To get the most out of this lecture, you should already be comfortable with the idea of a relation as a set of ordered pairs, since this lecture extends that idea to relations between more than two things. This extension makes the mathematical definition of relation a little more widely useful, and is also the foundation for relational databases in computing. So sit back and enjoy the lecture. The usual textbook definition says that a relation R between members of a set A is a set of ordered pairs of members of A. In other words, R is a subset of A cross A. For instance, the less than relation on real numbers is a set of ordered pairs of reals containing, for example, the pair 0, 1, since 0 is less than 1, negative 1, pi, for a similar reason, 17.37832, and so forth. There is no reason, however, why a relation has to only involve pairs of values. For example, consider a sum-to relation S between triples of real numbers, A, B, C, that holds whenever A plus B equals C, i.e., when A and B sum to C. So, for example, the triple 2, 2, 4 is in the sum 2 relation because 2 plus 2 equals 4. 0, 1, 1 is in the relation because 0 plus 1 equals 1. 5, negative 2.1, 2.9 is in it because 5 plus negative 2.1 equals 2.9, and so forth. We can describe this relation formally as a set of ordered triples, each being a member of the reals crossed with themselves again. Exactly those triples in which the first member plus the second equals the third are in this set. In general, relations can be defined on any number of values, 2, 3, 4, etc. Within any one relation, every member will always contain the same number of values, so, for example, you'll never see a relation that contains both pairs of values and triples. But you will certainly see some relations that contain pairs, for example, less than, and other relations that contain triples, such as sum to, and maybe ones that contain quadruples or quintuples or even larger groups. A relation defined on groups of n values is called nAry, and the groups within it are ordered n tuples, or tuples for short. Another variation on relations is to drop the requirement that the tuples in a relation come from the n-fold cross product of a set with itself, and instead allow them to come from the cross product of any n sets, some of which may be the same as others, but don't have to be. For example, the contact list in a telephone is a relation between people's names and their telephone numbers. You could think of this relation as being on a set in which some members are people's names and others are telephone numbers, and it's just an amazing coincidence that every tuple has a name as its first element and a phone number as its second. But the real-world significance of the relation is clearer if you think of it as being on two sets, one of which contains names and the other of which contains numbers. As this example suggests, whether relations are cross products of multiple sets or of only one with itself is really just a technical distinction, but it can make the formal definition of relation a little easier to appreciate. And of course, this variation isn't limited to relations on pairs of values, it works for any relation. You've now seen how to extend the idea of pairwise or binary relations to general nAry ones. The key idea is that a relation is a set of ordered n tuples, which are all members of a cross product of some n sets. This concludes the lecture. Thank you for watching, and I hope you found it interesting.